And now it's time for On the Money with your host, Dan White. Dan has been in the financial services industry for over 25 years, and he's been a featured expert in Forbes, Yahoo, the Philadelphia Business Journal, Dow Jones Market Watch, and has appeared nationally on Fox Business News. Dan is a member of some of the most prestigious financial organizations, including the Society of Financial Service Professionals and the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors. In addition, he's a chartered life underwriter and a chartered financial consultant. Credentials you can trust. Broadcasting from the heart of Wilmington, Delaware, here's your host of On the Money, Dan White.
Did you ever hear your doctor say to you, "I really wish I would have saw you in my office earlier"? Well, the reason they say this is because people who delay or skip appointments end up presenting a huge challenge for medical professionals, how to catch up with a health issue that's gotten too hard to treat. Well, what's true for the physical doctor is also true for fiscal doctors. It's something you should keep in mind when it comes to retirement planning. Welcome to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White. I am the host of your show. And this morning, we're going to talk about things that you got to plan for before retirement. And in particular, we're going to talk about how inflation is making life difficult for a whole lot of people. Before we get into the program, though, we do have a couple announcements. This coming Thursday is D-Day, you know, June the 6th. D-Day. So we're coming off of Memorial Day where we celebrated, the heroes who have given the ultimate sacrifice for our country. And D-Day is right up there with them. So on Thursday, please keep in mind what D-Day represents. Also, we have our Lewis, Delaware ribbon cutting ceremony for our new office down in Lewis. That will be held Thursday, June the 6th from 4 to 6 p.m. We're going to have food trucks, drinks, raffle prizes, some giveaways, and all local residents and business owners are welcome to attend. For more information, call our events coordinator, Chris, at 610-472-7626 or go to events at danwhiteandassociates.com. We do have a giveaway today. Our giveaway is a white paper called Using Income Riders for Retirement Goals. We talk a lot about guaranteed income on the program, and income riders are a great way to get guaranteed income. So if you'd like to find out how they work and why they work with a lot of retirees, then pick up the phone and give us a call. You can reach us toll-free at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820 in Pennsylvania. It's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. We have two upcoming events this week. On Monday, June the 3rd at 5:30 p.m., we'll be down at Cantwell's Tavern in Odessa, Delaware. And then on Wednesday, June the 5th, we'll be out at the Marshallton Inn in Westchester, PA. And both of these programs start at 5:30. Both of them will be today's retirement concerns and solutions. So if you've got questions about your retirement, when to take Social Security, whether or not to take a lump sum or a pension payout, which accounts to draw down from, these are programs you don't want to miss. So pick up the phone and get a reservation as quickly as possible. So, you know, we talked about physical health, and it's always good to catch things early. Well, it's the same thing with fiscal health. And if I had a nickel for everybody that came into our office and said, "Oh, I really wish I would have came in about 5 years ago." Well, the bottom line is this. Planning before you retire is a lot easier. You work, you save through good times and bad. You work more, you save more. And when you get to retirement, you have what you have, and hopefully that is enough. Retirement planning after you retire is not that easy at all. Besides turning our retirement savings into a regular income, we worry about longevity. We worry about how long we're going to live. We worry about health care costs. We worry about market losses. We worry about inflation. And inflation is really what I need to talk about today. You might hear the expression retirement ruin more today and in the future. Running out of money in retirement is called retirement ruin because running out of money will certainly ruin anyone's retirement. Last month, an annuity carrier published the results of a survey of 1,000 adults nationally. Two out of three Americans worried more about running out of money than they worried about dying. I mean, think about that, right? Two out of three, they're more worried about being broke than dead. They'd rather be dead than broke. It's crazy. And Gen Z and millennials worried more about this than baby boomers. Go figure. So inflation can have a dangerous effect on our retirement income and retirement savings. You know, in the past, we've called it the stealth tax. It's really not a tax, but if everything becomes more expensive in retirement, then in a way, you know, it is a tax. Inflation reduces the value of our money. Our money just buys less when prices go up. After inflation, we need to spend more money to purchase the same goods and services. Our lifestyle is more expensive after inflation. And we could give you example after example after example. You know, when I was growing up, I think gas was about a quarter a gallon. You know, you could get a bubble gum for a penny. You know, these things, and now look at what things cost today. It's crazy. People react in different ways to inflation. Some people spend more money than they planned on. Others tighten their belt and reduce their standard of living. Some people take more investment risk to earn a rate of return high to stay even with inflation. Well, spending more money than you planned or taking more investment risk can lead to disaster. Spending less money to cope with inflation would not be fun. You're reducing your lifestyle, and it does not seem like a good long-term strategy. The simple fact is that higher inflation increases the risk of running out of money during retirement while you still have good years of living remaining in your life. A study just published by the Center for Retirement Research at Boston College and quoted in the Wall Street Journal said high inflation later in life is often harmful to retirement security. It noted that inflation causes higher withdrawals and a decline in wealth. I mean, think about it. Years ago, people had pensions. And inflation, I mean, pensions were kind of a fixed income. Pensions, Social Security has a cost of living. Then we'll talk about that. But if you're living on a fixed income and prices go up, I mean, you know, if inflation's 3%, prices are going to double every 24 years. If inflation's 5%, every 14 years. So if prices go up and you have a fixed income, you're either going to buy less, you're going to cut into your standard of living, it's going to cause problems. But today, you know, people don't, they're on fixed incomes, but they have nest eggs. So again, to keep your standard of living the same, you've got to take higher withdrawals just to buy the same goods and services. So bringing inflation down to the 2% level is the goal of the Federal Reserve Board. That's their bogey, if you will. They want to get to 2%. Doing that will reduce the level of risk in the economy and the investment markets. It will allow all of us to make financial decisions for the future with much less risk and uncertainty. We know how important lower inflation is to retirement planning for the reasons said earlier and more. So how is the Federal Reserve doing with their fight against inflation? I mean, inflation jumped higher 3 years ago in the spring of 2021, and it did not stop increasing until 15 months later when it hit 9.1%. We remember that, right? And that was a direct response to all the stimulus from COVID, you know, and they should have cut rates earlier and they didn't, but they, you know, should have raised rates earlier and they didn't. In early May, the U.S. Department of Labor announced that the rate of inflation was 3.4% compared to April of 2023. The core inflation rate was the lowest since April of 2021 at 3.6%. So the Fed is kind of doing a high wire circus act. They raised interest rates from 0% to over 5% to fight inflation. And they thought it would kind of grind the economy to a halt, right? They'd throw us into recession and then inflation would come down. You know, unemployment, but here's the bottom line. Unemployment has barely increased and there has been no recession. Investment markets now expect the Fed to lower interest starting sometime this year, but it hasn't happened yet. And that's very good news so far. The bad news, if that's what it is that prices are probably staying at the height of the levels that we have today. If the Fed brings inflation down to 2%, that is still an increasing cost for most goods and services. If prices started to fall, we would be worried about deflation, and that would be a different kind of bad news, perhaps caused by a recession and or a stock market crash. So we certainly do not need or expect that, so we are where we are. And I've said this numerous times in the past, you know, everybody's all gung-ho about rate cuts. You know, oh, we're going to have rate cuts. The market loves rate cuts. And I keep saying to people that when the Fed decides to cut rates, I mean, it means we're in trouble. You know, the economy is in trouble. The recession is at hand. And I might have mentioned this in previous shows, but when the Fed starts a rate hiking cycle, it is generally 26 months before the recession kicks in. Well, guess what? We're at 24, maybe 25 months. So, you know, if history holds true, a recession could be starting soon. And they just downgraded GDP from the first quarter. They had it 1.6, and then they did a revision. Now it's down to 1.3. And this is compared to 3.4% in the fourth quarter of last year. So we went from 3.4 to 1.3. So I would say the economy is starting to roll over. It's starting to happen. We're seeing layoffs. You know, we're seeing companies miss earnings. We had Target missed. Their stock dropped 8% in a day. McDonald's, Starbucks, all the things that middle America buys on a daily basis, we're all seeing to see cracks in the armor. Let me give you our phone numbers. Toll free, you can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. This morning, we're talking about how our war, the Federal Reserve's war on inflation, is going. The first leg has been okay, but now it's like losing those last 10 pounds. It gets a little trickier. We'll have more on this after the break.
When interest rates go down, you may refinance your mortgage. When interest rates go up like they are now, what do you do with your retirement planning? Have you considered refinancing or reevaluating your current retirement plan? We are now seeing historically high interest rates that can impact your retirement accounts in different ways. Learn how you can take advantage of these attractive rates and how you can seek to avoid the volatility that rising rates create. To learn more, go to danwhiteandassociates.com or call 888-690-8820.
Welcome back to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White. I am the host of your show. And this morning we've been talking about that stealth tax inflation, what it means for people close to retirement today, how it affects them, and what are some strategies we can use to protect ourselves from this inflation. And we're going to continue along this track, but I do have a couple announcements today. We have a giveaway. It's a white paper called Using Income Riders to Meet Retirement Goals. I mean, you know, guaranteed income, I can't stress it enough. I don't think anybody can ever have enough guaranteed income. And that's what income riders do. They provide guaranteed income to people in retirement. So if you'd like to really dig a little deeper into how these things work, pick up the phone and give us a call. We're happy to send you out our white paper. You can reach us toll-free at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. We have two upcoming events this current week. On Monday, June the 3rd at 5:30 p.m. we'll be at Cantwell's Tavern in Odessa, Delaware. And then on Wednesday, June the 5th, also at 5:30, we'll be out at the Marshalton Inn in Westchester, PA. And both of these programs are our very popular in-person dinner seminars, Today's Retirement Concerns and Solutions. These programs provide important information on various retirement topics that help you make informed and educated decisions regarding your personal retirement planning needs. So if you'd like to come out to one of our upcoming events, pick up the phone and give us a call. Get a reservation as quickly as possible. So again, when we talk about inflation, you know, the financial press kind of watches inflation like a hawk. And interest rates, too. The Wall Street Journal published an editorial in March titled, hold the inflation champagne. They don't expect inflation to fall from where we are today to the Fed's goal of 2%. And as a result, they are warning all those waiting for the Fed to start cutting interest rates to wait a little while longer. And that seems to be the mantra this year. You know, we came into the beginning of the year, you know, they were projecting. The Fed originally said, Jerome Powell originally said in November, probably 3 interest rate cuts this year. Somehow that morphed in the financial press to 6 rate cuts, and they were going to start in March. Well, March came and went. The first 3 months, the inflation numbers were going the wrong direction, so that didn't happen. Then they said May. May came and went. We did have a little drop in May from, I guess, in April on our inflation numbers. You know, a key number comes out today. So we don't know. We don't know where we're at with this. Now they're talking about September with a rate cut. And a leading columnist for Bloomberg News, Alison Schrager, said in April that the interest rates that matter most, those for bonds, mortgages, and business loans, could easily be higher for forever. Think about that. We've had historically low rates for a long time. I mean, probably too low, or, you know, manipulating the system, if you will. We could easily have returned to rates that are normal when compared with the rates of the past 5 decades or longer. If that happens, we would all have to adjust to higher interest rates and maybe even 3% long-term inflation. You know, I get a kick out of this because the Fed's goal was 2. But if you look at our country over the past 110 years, inflation has averaged 3.2%. So I don't know where the 2% come from. We would all adjust. We've been living with 3% inflation forever. At least we would have interest rates high enough to earn enough interest to live on and support a reasonable retirement lifestyle. I mean, let's face it, we have positive interest rates. For years, we had negative interest rates, right, when adjusted for inflation. But now you can get 5% on a savings account, and if inflation's 3, hey, you're staying ahead of the game, right? I mean, that's the goal. A rising national debt could apply pressure for higher interest rates, or even some government fix to Social Security or Medicare or Medicaid. I think these forces will cause income taxes and other taxes to increase over time. The cost of government borrowing has increased with higher interest rates, and the amount of borrowing is increasing too much each year. So at some point, this will be a factor. The options for dealing with inflation are different for those not yet retired compared to those already retired. Those not yet retired very probably have options to increase their savings or reduce their expenses, or most importantly, to work longer than they originally planned. Those are 3 primary ways to fight inflation's impact on your future retirement. Increase your savings, reduce your expenses, or work longer. Okay, which, you know, some of them are not good options. Retirement planning already bears a considerable amount of uncertainty. I mean, that's life, you might say. Well, sure, it is, but you can try to do something about that uncertainty. You can work to create a higher margin of safety in your retirement plan. You do that by increasing the probability of not outliving your money. And if you are already retired, you probably have some idea of how your retirement planning is working and will continue to work. You can tell if your Social Security or other income, plus your withdrawals from your retirement savings, will be enough. You understand your general retirement budget, at least for the present. If you have a substantial retirement ruin risk, you probably know about that already as well. And if you are already retired and want to increase your margin of safety, you might try to reduce your expenses. You also might meet with a financial advisor to try to increase your rate of return without taking more risk. Or you might buy more guaranteed income using an annuity. That is a way to get more income out of the same or lesser amounts of dollars than just making withdrawals, and your new income could be guaranteed for life. If you have the ability to work part-time, that brings in new income and can reduce your retirement savings withdrawals. It's interesting, when we run reports for people, we call them, you know, cash flows. And I'm like, you know, oh, we didn't put any cash flows in your retirement projections. What would that be? That would be maybe you want to do some consulting. Maybe you want to take a part-time job. Maybe you have a rental property. I mean, you know, if you have that, that's great. But a lot of times we don't include it in our projections. But these things increase. They increase your margin of safety and decrease your chance of retirement ruining. If you are well into your retirement years, you might be comfortable with your position and know you have spending flexibility. Whatever you can do to reduce expenses in small ways, you can do that. And maybe just for this year only, taking a wait-and-see approach to next year and beyond. If you're well into retirement, you would not have to make your savings and income last as long as someone who is just beginning retirement. And as we said, running out of money in retirement is retirement ruin. We work hard to avoid that however we can. Our strategies are intended to raise the probability that you will not or cannot run out of money. What can we do when we are concerned about inflation that will increase our probability that we have enough income and net worth to last the full length of our lives? But there is good news inside this otherwise inflation bad news. By boosting the return on the safe fixed income portion of your savings, higher yields can reduce the risk of retirement ruin. Today's interest rates, although they are caused by inflation, are much better for savers than for borrowers. I mean, think back. We always said the goal was, hey, you have $1 million in the bank and you're getting 5%. That's 50 grand. You know, 5 years ago, you had $1 million in the bank and you were making 5 grand, you know. So that is a definite positive. You can probably lower your allocation to stock market investments and take less risk. Last year, the safe withdrawal rate was 3%. This year, it might be 4%. Maybe next year, 2025, there might be 4.5% or even more. That is what higher interest rates have the potential to do. They can provide the prospect of higher paydays throughout retirement. And Social Security is the best inflation insurance available today. That is why we work to maximize Social Security benefits. When your COLA, your cost of living adjustment, is made to a larger number, you have more inflation insurance. There is less pressure on the rest of your plan. Conversely, those with pensions and the interest from bonds, annuities, and CDs usually do not have inflation protection. And if you have an actual retirement income plan, you want to monitor it closely for both the inflation risk and the retirement ruin risk. If you have a plan, you probably are working with a financial professional. Talk to her or him about the concerns you may have. The sooner you see a potential problem, the easier it is to do something about it. And you should probably review your budget and expenses every year, even if you only do that at a very high level. When your concern is inflation, you want to identify those expenses you have that are impacted by inflation. And obviously, if you have higher interest loans or carry a credit card balance, can you pay those down or eliminate those loans and credits? Those rates are also higher today because rates have increased. Reducing or eliminating your debt obligations is as good as earning the rate you have been paying. Let me give you our phone numbers. Toll free, you can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942. 610-358-8942. Inflation is here. It's real. Costs go up all the time. Hopefully, we've given you strategies today to deal with these increasing costs. But if you've got questions, we can help you with the answers. Pick up the phone and give us a call. Have a great week.
The views and opinions expressed on this program are those of their respective parties and not those of this show's producers or this station. Join us again for more on